your speech. Katie and I met when I was still in high school visiting Penn for Quaker Days, during which I attended an a cappella workshop led by the legendary Quaker Notes. After an introduction, we split off into groups, all excited to learn a piece of a real college a cappella arrangement. But my group's lovely leader, Katie, decided it would be much more fun to sit and chat with us rather than teach us any part of the song. Which is not even remotely surprising if you know anything at all about Katie. We like literally did not sing one note. Anyway, I definitely liked her at the time, and she gave me a great first impression of the seriousness of collegiate a cappella. But regardless, I had zero idea that she would end up being such a huge part of the heart and soul of Quaker Notes and become one of my best friends in the world. It's hard to account for all the traits that Katie has because it always seems like she's got them all. If I were to ask her to sum it up, I know she would probably say, "I'm fun and flirty." Every aspect of herself. But well, of course she is fun and I guess flirty. There are infinite other ways I would describe her beyond that. She's uplifting and always incredibly thoughtful. She's a talker, a laugher, and the definition of a people person. She's one of the kindest and most caring people I know. She not only knows to have fun, but she makes sure every single other person around her has fun too. She never fails to make anyone smile or laugh, even if that was not her intention. And she has a presence that cannot be missed during rehearsals, or in any setting for that matter. And of course, everyone you already know, she has an incredibly unique, beautiful, sultry voice, to the point where we sometimes have to make a conscious effort not to feature her solo at every gig. Simply put, she's amazing, and the world would be a better place if everyone was a little bit more like her. Yeah! Group when I say that the thing we'll miss most about you is your enthusiastic hand movements when you're singing background. It's just an effortless contribution at our rehearsals and performances that cannot be replaced. Obviously, your constant Michael Scott-inspired commentary will be missed as well, but definitely not as much as the hand movements. No, in all seriousness though, I have no idea what Quaker Notes and Penn will be like without you next year, but I'm not ready to find out. You've impacted me and so many other people here more than you'll ever know. You've been here with me right from the start with your contagious optimism through the best and the worst times, and there's no one I would have rather had by my side. And wherever the wind takes you after this, whether you're marketing water purifiers in Uganda, or you finally get your minivan and become a professional babysitter right here in Philly, that place and those people are so incredibly lucky to have you. During these last 3 years, thank you for being my keynotes mom, my pal, my rock, my running buddy, my alto buddy, my strat sister, and the slightly frustrating but mostly funny girl at rehearsals who cracks a witty joke at too many moments when we're trying to get a room to focus. I love you in every way, shape, and form, and I can't wait to be a part of your life forever and ever. Now go sing your heart out.